Hello, Klaus here, and welcome to a very quick new video. With Halloween approaching, I thought it would be fun just to show how to do a basic little Halloween shot with this plastic skull here and a couple of other things. So that's what we're going to do in this video here. And I am going to use a fog machine. If you do not have a fog machine, I am also going to show you how you could do the same effect but without a fog machine. So without further ado, let's get right to the video. So we are just going to give it a little bit of fog, like that. And that is already a lot. So we want to spread this around a little bit. Going to give it a little bit more smoke. And that was a lot more smoke. Of course, if you want the smoke to be moving more around the ground and stuff like that, we would need to do something with dry ice, but we don't have dry ice and that can be a bit hard to get. So that's why we're just doing regular smoke here. So let's try to shoot this. There we go. And let's trigger the... So here we are in DaVinci Resolve. If you're interested in learning about the light setup, I'll come back to that in just a sec. But here we have this clip here where there are smoke in the background. It's not super noticeable, but it's there. And just to spice up this Halloween theme a little bit up, I'm going to do a little bit of an effect in this one. Super simple one. So I'm going to go into Fusion, like that. And I'm going to take my media in and I'm just going to Control C. And Control V, so I'll do a copy of that. And I don't really need it to merge yet, at least. So I'm just going to kill off the merge and connect this to the media out. So what I want to do is I want to make, let's say I want some blood to run out of the eye or something like that. Let's do that super fast. First off, I'm going to take a background node and I'm going to take a polygon and I'm going to put that right here. Okay, and I'll go here to the last keyframe and I'm just going to push Alt Option and use the middle mouse wheel here to zoom in. And I'm going to draw a shape here. So you can make it just the way you want, but I think like some kind of a bloody thing here. So I'm going to add this to the background and I'm going to take my background and add that into my media in to do a merge node. Now we have this black thing here and I don't want that. So I'm going to go into the background and I'll change the color to red. And that's not really that red. So I'm going to that instead, and I'm going to take down the red color just a bit because it's a little too cartoony. I'm going to take out the green and I'm also going to take down the blue. Still a little bit cartoony, but for this that'll work just fine. Then I'll go into the polygon and I'm going to soften the edges just a little bit, not that much, just a tiny bit. That, and then you know I can do the same with the border width. I can put that up or down a little bit, something like that. Cool. And then what I want to do now is I'll go to the beginning keyframe, which is all the way back here, and then I'm just going to highlight these ones and I'm going to move this up. I'll highlight here and I'm going to move up my drawing here like so. Then I'll highlight here, move up. And, you know, I'll just continue to do this until the eye here, or the blood of the eye, is away. Like that. There we go. I'm just going to move this a little bit up. that. There we go. And this is a super simple trick, by the way. So here we go. So if we just run the trick or the clip now, you can see that this is blood running out of the eye. And of course, this looks a little bit silly because of, well, you guessed it, the border and everything. But we're going to fix that right now. So we're going to take the media we copied right here. I'm going to push one on the keyboard so I can see this over here. And then again, I'm going to push the Alt and zoom in and use the middle mouse button here to move everything around. Then I'll just take a polygon and I'm going to zoom in a bit here. And I'm going to do a mask here around the eye. So you can do this super detailed or like I'm doing, pretty rough. You don't actually have to do the entire eye, but I'm just doing that. So the only place where you have to be very careful is around here. So, and I'm going to connect this together. So now we have the eye, and then I'm just going to put this right in here in the merge. And now that is going to create a mask, of course, you know, and then you can have an effect looking like that, and you can add in a color grade or something like that. And we're going to have an effect looking like this. And if you really want to, you can add some kind of a vintage look using either the Motion VFX 16mm, which are really cool. And you can see a review of that down in the description below if you want to. Or you can use the damage video or the analog inside of DaVinci Resolve. Now let's have a look at how the lighting setup is for this thing. So this is a very simple setup I'm doing for this shot. I am having my object here, the skull, out of the frame here. I have a bounce board, and that's coming from the soft box, pushing light into that, and that's bouncing off. And then I also have out here another light, which I do need my phone to use. So this is the Arrowman light from Aperture. And I have this trigger effect here. So I'm triggering that from the app here. So I can just trigger and I have like a lighting effect. And that's what I'm using. And the light itself has a Snoke on. And just to make the all round light a little bit smaller. But other than that, that's the basic lighting setup for this. And now we're just going to shoot this very simple shot without the smoke. And then I'll show you in post in just a little bit how to fix that in DaVinci Resolve. So let's shoot the shot here. Turn on the camera and let's have our little shot here. Okay, so now we're just going to shoot that like that, and I'm going to push my lightning here. So just like that, let's jump in post. And here we are back in DaVinci Resolve, and here we have the shot with the no smoke. And I'll quickly show you how you could add smoke into your footage. And this time we'll go into the color page. And in the color page, I'm just going to push Alt S to add a new note. So let's add in some smoke. And we can do that with the fast noise. Fast noise, it's right here. I'm going to add that into my second note. And here we have that. And now you can't see anything, but it has a preset. And the preset is smoke. So we're going to put in some smoke. We can then go into the scale and scale it up quite a bit. So if we just push play here, we can see that we have smoke. However, I want to have the smoke in the background and not in the foreground. And since we are here and we are doing this in the color page, we can actually mask out things. So we are quickly going to mask out the skull here. And, you know, I'm just going to select the mask and I'm going to very quickly do a selection here. And of course you could do a way better job than I'm doing, but for the sake of this tutorial, we are just going to keep it pretty fast. So there we go. I'm going to take off the mask, and then we can go into the softness and go into the inside of the mask here and make that either smaller or bigger, or we can take some of this out like that. And you know, you can mess around with this as much as you want to make it look exactly the way you want. So now the smoke is a little too strange, so I'll go into the adjustment here. And you know, I can either use the brightness, or I can use the contrast, or the saturation if I want to change the colors and make it very funky, but I don't really want to do that. Also, I can go into the evolution of the smoke here and make it a little more, you see, kind of make it move a little more smoke-like. And I can do the details here so it will not be as harsh, something like that. And then last, you know, I can go into the global blend and I can just take that down quite a bit. And now we have smoke here in the bag. Put it down a little more. Here we have some smoke added into the bag. Pretty fast, pretty easy. And of course you can combine this technique with what I did just before, adding in blood and making an eye red or something like that. Or you could add some kind of camera movements using the tools available in the Inspector. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.